Hello everyone, it's me, Yanni and Jane once again. I'm also known as Dr. Chia Yin Nin. This video, we're going to talk about weight loss. We're going to talk about why is that important. It is particularly important for people who are overweight. Now, we all know that obesity is associated with a lot of health issues. Obese people are more prone to the three highs, which is high blood pressure, diabetes and cholesterol. And these three are associated with heart disease and stroke. So it is not uncommon to hear young men or even older men in their prime of their life, 40s, dropping dead because of heart attack or have a stroke, you know, and have to be bed bound. The same actually applies to women. All of us, whether we are women or we're men, we're all at risk. Women in our younger days, we might be protected because of our female hormones, but as we near menopause, where we do not have our female hormones to protect us, that's where we run the risk of having the three chronic illnesses. Obesity remains the major risk factors for the three chronic illnesses, and I think it is important that all women stay healthy and stay within normal BMI. Now, weight loss is never an easy journey. Not all of us are so blessed. Not all of us are born thin. Most of us are born a little bit on the weighty side, and most of us are born a little greedy. Yeah. So a lot of the time, it is our diet, exercise also play a role. Now, from diet, I always advocate as a doctor to maintain a healthy lifestyle. I don't believe in fat diet. That means sudden detox diet in which you go on a juicing diet for 3 months, or you go on a ketogenic diet for 3 months. All this fat diet, they will work. The issue is that can you translate that to long-term maintenance? So a lot of people, when they go on a fat diet, they lose the weight, but they find that the weight rebound the minute they go back to their usual practice. As a doctor, what I advocate is a lifestyle change. You need to start first from yourself. You must want to lose the weight. You must want to recognize that weight obesity is an issue. Do not wait until you are stuck down with stroke or heart disease. Obesity, besides these three illnesses, also causes cancer like colorectal cancer, uterine cancer. So please do not wait till you have all these problems before you embark on the journey. So the minute you decided that yes, I want to lose weight, then you embark on the journey. So number one is diet. So as I mentioned, I advocate a healthy lifestyle, healthy eating. So diet, basic rules, the pyramid still holds. I believe in a complex carbs diet. So take your rice, take your carbs, but take them whole grain. Brown rice, quinoa, wholemeal bread, wholemeal pasta. Please avoid refined sugars. Please avoid white rice, white bread. They are very, very high in GI. Take food that's low in GI and take food that will release energy for you over a long period. Next, up the pyramid is fruits and vegetables. Please take a lot of fruits and vegetables. Number one, they're very high in minerals and antioxidants. Number two, they're high in fiber. They make you feel full. They help you with your bowel movement, decrease the risk of colorectal cancer. Top of the pyramid, that's where you take your protein and your fats. Now, it is important to take some fats, not completely to avoid, but please take the healthy fats. So we're talking about good fats like your olive oil, you know, like your avocado. Please avoid pork lard, yeah. I mean, they are nice once in a while, yes. If you're healthy 90% of the time, then by all means take your char kway teow with pork lard. Once in a blue moon, you know. But if you're unhealthy all the time, please do not, yeah. Then avoid processed fats like margarine. It's better to take a little bit of butter than to take a whole lot of margarine. And oil is still an oil. Even though they are good oil, like olive oil, you still need to take that in moderation. So for me, I advocate a well-balanced diet. 70%, 60% complex carbs, 40% fruits, vegetables, and then maybe 10-20% protein. Cook them in a healthy way So use the air fryer, avoid deep fried, try to steam, try to bake, you know, try to stir fry with little oil. You know, you can buy ceramic pots and use less oil. But in short, use less oil, healthy way of cooking. Yeah. Now Jane here will tell you, testify, she has tried a lot of diet. Yeah, from young, you know, she tried all sorts of diet. She tried to lose weight. Her mother said she cannot lose weight once she's born fat. Fat bone, big size, you know.
Yeah, just to add, my family, they are all a bit on the obese, fatter side. So I am considered like the slimmer one of the family. So since young, I am the best of the family already. Think that like I am the thinnest and everything. But actually, in fact, I think I am still fat, like according to her.
She was 62 kilos, yeah. And now she is 48.
Yeah, so yeah. Like, following Dr. Chia's advice, what I did was I changed my entire diet around. So I used to take high protein, a lot of meat, less rice. So that was like the main thing that I was doing for many, many years. So like I could lose some weight, but it was to a very limited extent. Like stuck at this weight for a very long time until like I started changing my diet all around. So what I did was I followed what she mentioned. I started on brown rice. So I had my main diet become like complex carbs with like vegetables and of course like meat on the side. But mainly what I did was I eat a lot of carbs. But of course to burn that carbs, right, I have to complement it with exercise. So I did everything that she said. So I eat all carbs and then evening I spend 1 hour jumping. I started from like 2 times, then 3 times, then 4 times, then 5 times, then 6 times a week. But I mean, in a way I enjoy jumping, so it's not a chore to me. So that's what I mean, what we will mention as like a lifestyle change, right?
So diet, as what Jade has shared, she changed her diet. So she started with some intermittent fasting, which we do advocate if you really want to kickstart your weight loss. That's about 14 to 16 hours of no food. You can drink water, you can drink green tea, black coffee, kosong. Yeah, the easiest way for us to embark on intermittent fasting for most people would be to just simply skip your breakfast. You skip your breakfast, you eat your last meal, for example, 8 p.m. By the next day, 8 a.m. is already 12 hours. If you eat your lunch at 12, that is already 16 hours. You know, so I advocate intermittent fasting to kickstart your weight loss. Then you do your lunch, a heavier lunch and a lighter dinner. Yeah, but everything is about in and out, calorie intake and calorie out. Yeah, so overall your food intake must balance off by output. So diet only helps you to kickstart so much. In the end, you need to maintain your metabolism or increase your metabolism. And the only way is exercise. There are many, many types of exercise. I always tell people, please choose the exercise that you like. Because only if you like the exercise, then you'll likely stay on. It can be anything. It can be Zumba, it can be boxing. I mean, for us, we really like jumping because we find jumping highly effective. It burns tremendous amounts of energy. The trampoline, it is very, very soft, absorb shock and impact, unlike the hard floor. So in long-term wise, it doesn't wear and tear your knee joint. And 10 minutes on the tram is like doing a 30-minute jog. It's much more time effective. So for busy people like us with a full-time job, we find that the trampoline fitness answers all. You know, 1 hour, burn tremendously, we have lots of fun, it doesn't injure us in any way. And at the end of the day, we had a good workout, we burn tremendous amount of calorie. So it depends on individual, depends on the weight of the individual. The calorie burn can range from 300, if you're a very small size like me, to even 1,000 for very big size people. So the calorie is not, you cannot compare everybody like, oh, I burn 300, but you burn 400. You know, you need to take into context of body size. A smaller size people will, like me will burn lesser. She's slightly bigger, she'll burn more. But average, you want to hit about 300 on average for a good burn. And exercise is important, not just once a week. Once a week will not achieve your result. You need to make sure that it's regular. Regular means at least 3 times a week. If you want it to be more effective, then 4 times, and then 5 times, and then 6 times.
we have not reached 7 kilos yet, so.
We give ourselves a break once a week. I mean, once a week, you can do something else, you know, like us, you go hiking, you go cycling, you know, whatever. Just keep active, okay? So exercise, diet play a key role. I mean, nowadays, we don't really do any other exercise. In the past, we used to do others. We tried Zumba, yoga, Pilates, they're still good, but they don't burn as much as jumping fitness. Jumping fitness really help you to lose your weight. But you must persevere, yeah? Must have the determination. Cannot jump already, like some of my jumpers, jump already, go and eat buffet, yeah? So you jump already, eat buffet, you jump already, drink your bubble tea, net zero, yeah? Net zero, okay? But a lot of time I find that weight loss, it must start from you. You must want to drink. You can bring the horse to the river. If the horse refuses to drink, nothing gets done. Yeah, so you must want to do it. Then if you want to do it, you know, just follow simple, healthy lifestyle advice, healthy diet, regular exercise, you will achieve your goal in no time. Aim for a gradual weight loss, gradual goals, not overnight weight loss. Don't aim for like 10 kg over 1 month. Yeah, you may lose it. You go to those weight loss center. A lot of time it's actually water loss. They show you immediate results, but it's actually all water loss. They will come back. What we want is a sustained weight loss. Aim for a weight loss over a 1 year period and then try to maintain. So Jane, how long have you maintained your current weight?
Let me count. 2 years. So because I count from the day I started buying my first ever rice cooker, that was in January 2019. So that was when I bought my rice cooker to cook brown rice. So from then to now, 2022 April. So 3 years.
Just maintained. And many of our jumpers out there actually have. One day we'll ask all of them to share. They're all somewhere out there. Yeah. Oh, Lawrence. Many has lost weight. Karen. Yeah. So one day we'll ask Ross to share with you guys their weight loss journey and how jumping fitness is a key in their weight loss journey. Thank you, Mia.
Thank you.
Hope to see you at Jumping Singapore.